So far in this series, we've talked about ways to make your queries faster, but you want your writes, inserts, updates, and deletes to be faster too, right? Let's find out how. Firstly, you want to ensure that you're finding the rows you want to change efficiently. You can do this by changing the write into a read. Do this for updates and deletes by querying the table using the same where clause. For insert a select, just remove the insert and run the query on its own. For insert using values, there is no query, so there's nothing to do here. But before you do this, combine your changes into as few SQL statements as possible. To see why, let's say I'm loading bricks from this box onto this table. I could do this by picking up the bricks one by one and putting them on the table. Clearly, this is going to take a while. It is much faster if I just pick up the whole box and tip them all out. Similarly, if I now decide I want to remove some of these bricks, it's going to take a while if I'm just picking them up one by one and putting them back in the box. It is much faster if I just wipe a whole bunch off in one go. It is the same with SQL statements. It is much faster to have one statement that changes many rows compared to having lots of statements which changes a couple of rows each. So make sure you're not making one of the biggest performance mistakes around: writing data inside loops. You can often make processes much faster by taking the write out of the loop and changing the code to one SQL statement. But once you've combined all your changes into one SQL statement, you may still find, particularly for updates and deletes of millions of rows, that your SQL takes too long to run. Luckily, for these large-scale updates and deletes, there is a trick available. Turn the DML into DDL. Let's say I want to remove most of the bricks available. Instead of deleting the ones I want to get rid of, I can save the ones I want to keep to another table and then switch the rows over. Do this by writing a query, finding the rows you want to keep, and save them by turning this into a create table as select. Complete the process by truncating the original table, an instant DDL operation, and copying the rows back from the new table to the original. You can use the same idea to make updates of millions of rows faster too. Or if you need to go faster still, you can do so by switching the tables over. Do this by using create table as select as before. Then switch the tables over by renaming or dropping the original and renaming the new table. If you choose to switch the tables over, to complete the process, you will need to copy any indexes, constraints, and so on from the old table to the new. This can still take a while, so to see whether it's faster than just switching the rows over, test both to see which is fastest. But in either case, the process is fiddly to write, and you'll need to take your application offline to complete it, making this technique infeasible for most of us. Luckily, Oracle Database does have a couple of other tricks up its sleeve: partitioning and filtered table moves. With partitioning, you logically split up one table into several smaller subtables. So you can split the rows up into effectively separate smaller subtables based on values in one or more columns. You can then do operations on the rows in just one partition. So we can get rid of all the rows in one partition easily by truncating or dropping it. Provided you want to remove all the rows in a partition, you can do so instantly by dropping or truncating it. Just remember that partitioning a table will affect all operations against it, all queries, inserts, updates, and deletes, some of which could get slower. So make sure you assess your whole workload before diving in with partitioning. If this turns out to be a non-starter for you, from Oracle Database 12.2, there is a much more lightweight way to remove lots of rows from a table, a filtered table move. Do this by adding a where clause to an alter table move command. This discards all the rows you want to remove, leaving the table with just the rows you want to keep. This is much easier than creating a temporary table and swapping the rows over. And you can do it online. But just remember, DDL in Oracle Database commits, meaning you cannot roll these changes back. If you made a mistake doing this, then you need to recover the lost data from some kind of backup. Take extra care before going ahead with these operations. But it's rare you need to change your DML processes into DDL. Usually, your process will change just a small fraction of the rows in the table. In which case, changing your code so you've got one SQL statement which changes all the rows is usually good enough. But you may still find that, unlike queries, there are other processes which are slowing down your writes. Two common culprits for this are blocking sessions and triggers. In Oracle Database, nothing blocks queries, but writes can be blocked by another session. So one process can stop another from completing. There are many possible reasons for this, but common ones include clashes on primary or unique keys for inserts and updates or deletes trying to change the same rows. For example, let's say we've got two sessions trying to insert the same primary key value. They both start at the same time, so can't see each other's data. This means that the second session has to wait for the first one to commit or roll back before it knows if it's trying to add a duplicate value. Similarly, if you have two sessions trying to update or delete the same rows, the second session has to wait for the first to commit or roll back before it can write its changes. To see if blocking locks are a problem for your application, check for them in your database monitoring tools. If they are, then you'll have to rewrite your processes to avoid the locks. But assuming that there are no blocking sessions affecting your statement, you may still find that the writes are slower than you expected. This could be because of triggers. These do extra work on top of your SQL. It's often the case that your SQL statement is fast enough. It is the work done in the trigger that really slows it down. If this is the case, again, to speed it up, you will need to rewrite the process, ideally without any triggers. So, to recap, the basic tuning process for writes is the same for queries. Get the SQL's execution plan and see if there's any indexes you need to create to make the process faster. Assuming you are finding the rows efficiently, look to see if there are any other processes which are slowing your SQL down. Common causes are blocking locks and triggers. Or if you're updating or deleting millions of rows in a table, you can often get good performance gains by changing the DML into DDL. But above all else, take SQL out of loops. The key to fast, efficient SQL is to have one statement that changes all the rows. Thanks for watching. There are, of course, many other things which could slow your writes down. But for this video, I wanted to focus on the common causes that you as a developer can implement. If you've got any questions on these, let us know in the comments. And subscribe for more SQL tips.